Thank you.
Presented before us are, how many? 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 22 consent orders, which I don't think any complainant or respondent is present.
No, ma'am, but I do apologize. 2010 and 44 and 45, you may want more information on before y'all accept it.
Okay.
That's the only issue.
I will ask, I have reviewed the consent orders as presented and did not have additional questions on any of them. I'm happy to hear additional information if you feel some is necessary, if you want to provide that on 44 and 45.
Yes, ma'am.
Moving on to case 2012-0063 in the matter of H4 Gravitt. Right.
Yes, ma'am.
Comments from staff, questions from the commission relative to the consent order? If there are none, is there a motion to approve the consent order as presented?
So moved.
Moved by Commissioner Adams, is there a second?
Second.
From Commissioner Kathy, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign, and the motion carries. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign, and the motion carries. And we certainly appreciate your good work in presenting 23 consent orders today. That is an undertaking of no small feat.
You just heard Corey say that Dana is the city's attorney.
Yeah,
he's got a letter from Dana saying he's not open record requests.
I told him that. I would also.
And Dana says I can't provide that.
I got lots of
can I do an open records request for a letter from your office saying that you are not the city attorney that was sent to me? One of your partners sent me a letter this past year saying that you are not the city attorney and that y'all just represent on an as-is basis.
Can I please finish this interview?
If you go right ahead, but that's an open records request.
It is not, sir.
To the city attorney, a verbal open record.
It is not.
So
we're just wondering, a three-member panel, you would carry some weight on that, and can you be impartial when this whole thing started over employees receiving or non-employees receiving insurance?
I don't believe that's what it's all about. It's all about Councilman Sexton making a plan or proposing a plan that would allow not only his wife, but other wives of council members to be able to be on a lifetime of health care insurance at the expense of the city. And of course, as I'm sure most people here know, that's a budget item that needs to be considered in open session.
Well, but the mayor's girlfriend's been receiving free insurance and she's not a city employee.
I'm not sure about that. I know she
is
insurance.
I can show you the documents. Yeah. I mean, we all have them. That's what's at issue here, right?
Sure.
So, and those documents are a matter of public record. It's an employee name, a hire date, financial information.
That's right.
All of those things are contained in pay stubs, which we receive under the Open Records Act all the time. How is that release of private information?
Because it's really not about the members of the mayor, council, and their wives. Release of information is about the 139 employees who are not elected officials.
They are city employees, though, and their paychecks are public information. We receive them all the time under the Open Records Act.
Their health insurance information is not public.
Not health information, financial
right.
information, which is all that's in that document. Are you seeing something here that we didn't see?
I believe that the information released is a potential violation, and again, we haven't done an investigation or a trial, so I can't prejudge the case. I believe it is a potential violation of both federal law, HIPAA, as well as state law, of items that are specifically protected from disclosure by the Open Meetings and Open Records Act of the state of Georgia.
So are you also going after the Human Resources Director for releasing those to the councilman?
No, because of course a councilman is entitled in his fiduciary capacity to be able to receive that information. It's the publication to third parties that are not councilmen or don't have a fiduciary duty to the city that constitutes the improper disclosure if in fact it occurred.
The HIPAA information is protected from anyone seeing it, not just a councilman. council member would not have access to HIPAA protected information.
As a general rule, that is correct.
So the HR director, under your view of all of this, violated that law as well?
I disagree with that.
Have you contacted the Attorney General's office for an opinion on this?
I have not, as of this
why
point.
Why wouldn't you have done so before you took this action today?
It's not my obligation to contact the Attorney General's office about it.
Why are you receiving health benefits through the city?
Because I'm the city attorney.
And is it in your contract?
It is in my whole agreement with the
but
city.
But it's not in your contract.
I don't have a written contract with the city. I serve at the pleasure of the city council.
Sure, and aren't there rules about who can actually receive health benefits?
Yes, and there are city attorneys across the state who receive health care benefits through the Georgia Municipal Association plan as part of their agreement to represent the city.
And what is that agreement that allows for people to receive health care through the city?
What is GMA's agreement? I don't know. I just know that I'm an eligible person because of the appointment that I received as city attorney.
And so are girlfriends and boyfriends of elected officials allowed to receive benefits as well?
I don't know about that.
Well, you must know me. Are girlfriends and boyfriends allowed to receive benefits?
Typically not.
So why is Mayor Gravitt's girlfriend receiving benefits?
I can't answer that question.
Well, isn't that a concern for the city attorney? Wouldn't you want to get to the bottom of that?
I understand that she was hired to do some specific tasks for the city, and her compensation for doing those tasks for the city, which was approved by the council, was that she would receive health care benefits.
And that was approved by the council, you say?
That's
can you tell me when it was approved by the council?
I do not know.
And do you know it was approved by the council?
That's what I have been told.
But you don't know that beyond a shadow of a doubt?
No, sir.
So wouldn't you go into look into that? You were talking about $75,000, taxpayer dollars that could be at risk, and you're taking a look at that compared to a document that may have been released that's actually public information? I'm trying to understand and balance the severity of those two issues. Can you please make sense? Because I think a lot of people out there don't understand
sure.
why the mayor himself isn't facing impeachment.
Sure, because Councilman Sexton's proposal would cost the city $1.8 million projected over time.
But that's a proposal.
With 1.5 of it going to
How is that worthy of impeachment? Because he made a proposal in executive session.
With all due respect, that's not the point. The point is the disclosure of the information outside of those who are allowed to review that information within the city.
Right, but the proposal has nothing to do with the release of the documents.
The proposal has everything to do with the release of the documents because of the statement that Councilman Sexton made, and within just a few hours after making that statement, which I certainly considered to be, he was very adamant about it. He was going to do what he had to do. He said it twice.
Did the mayor ask you to pursue this impeachment?
I'm not at liberty to talk about attorney-client privilege communications. Obviously, the mayor and the city council are my clients.
And at what point are you privileged to discuss what happened in executive session? Because as I understand it, that's supposed to be off limits to the public.
It is, and I haven't discussed what happened in executive session beyond the purpose that we went into, the fact that it was adjourned, and after the adjournment, Councilman Sexton made that comment. Other questions? Thank you very much.
Thanks, Mr. Moss.
Good evening, everyone. It's 6 o'clock. February the 17th, regular city council meeting night. So welcome, everyone.
I'd like to request that the council consider adding on a response from the Attorney General and a request for reconsideration.
Okay. Any others?
I guess it could be old business or new business. One of them would be actions to remove Angela Mullinax and Dana Miles from the insurance plan because neither meets the requirements set forth at GMA. Mr. Miles says he's only got a verbal agreement. His firm has been paid by the city of Cumming $860,094.11 in the past 3 years. Mr. Miles can pay his own health insurance. Item number two, hiring a full-time attorney with a yearly salary, office in the city hall, and provide benefits. This will save the city money. Number three, conflict of interest. Mr. Miles represented the city of Cumming in the last election, represented the mayor and Georgia Government Transparency Campaign Finance Commission, case 2012-0063. I think the Bar of Georgia and the Ethics Commission should look at this action. That's my three motions.
Okay, let's take them individually. Okay, I hear a motion on request, Councilman Sexton. I think this is things that's been just covered in the subpoenas that were sent there in request of myself, Angie Mullinax, and Daniel Miles. All this is covered in the subpoena.
I still make a motion that be added on.
You making a motion? Do I have a second? Motion dies for lack of a second. Okay, now I hear a motion to adopt the agenda as presented. Amen. I have a motion. Have a second. Have a second. In discussion. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? 3-1. Councilman Sexton opposed with Councilman Perry absent. Okay, the third item on the agenda is consideration of executive session, Councilman.
Mr. Mayor, we need an executive session or request one, please, for pending litigation.
Need executive session for our litigation?
For pending litigation, yes, sir.
Okay. I hear a motion we adjourn. Adjourn to an executive session. I have a motion, I have a second. All in favor? Adjourn. We'll try not to be very long. Hiring of an alternate counsel. Cruiser Mitchell is requesting LRP from, I think Kevin Dallas going to present this.
Mr. Mayor, thank you, members of the council. This is an item that has been added on through ratification that had been previously taken. I'll explain how this came up. As the city knows, received anti-libel notice from council who I think at least formerly represented Councilman Sexton. As a result of that, the city's insurance carrier hired a law firm, Cruiser Mitchell, to represent the city in regards to any kind of potential litigation that might have been filed arising out of that. After that, alternate counsel was retained by the insurance carrier, the city received three subpoenas and documents from the U.S. Attorney's Office. One of them included requests for information about Daniel Miles, who is, of course, the city attorney. When we received that subpoena, I immediately notified the city administrator that my law firm, I'm a partner of Mr. Miles, that my law firm should not be the one that represents the city in responding to that those subpoenas. Obviously, those subpoenas were issued to the city. The city is our client as long as Mr. Miles is the city attorney. But because he was mentioned in those subpoenas, it was my determination that we could not represent the city in that, so we recommended the hiring of another firm to represent the city's interest in responding to that subpoena. Because of the familiarity of Cruiser Mitchell with regard to the issues that involved the anti-libel notice that was received from Mr. Dillard, on behalf of Councilman Sexton, it was my recommendation that so that the city could handle this efficiently, that Cruiser and Mitchell be the law firm that the city retained to represent the city's interest with regard to those subpoenas and help the city in responding to those subpoenas. Upon that recommendation, the city administrator then engaged Cruiser and Mitchell, and I believe that under the charter and your administration provisions of the code that he has the authority to do that. But it's our recommendation that the council ratify that decision at this point so there's no question as to the propriety of Cruiser and Mitchell assisting the city representing the city's interest when it comes to the response to those subpoenas. Are there any questions?
Who's paying for this? The city?
At this point, my understanding is that the city has not received a bill for that. And I don't mean to be coy about that, Councilman Sexton. My understanding is that when Cruiser and Mitchell submits a bill, they are going to submit it to the city's insurance carrier, and then the city's insurance carrier will determine whether or not it's part of the covered expense. I just don't know the answer to the question at this point. I am sure that the city, if the bill ultimately comes to the city, would pay the bill, which is one of the reasons we want to have this ratification in place. But at this point, it's not determined whether the city is going to have to pay anything for Cruiser and Mitchell services in regards to these subpoenas or not.
Well, I've got a bill I'd like to present to somebody. Okay, would that be the city or would that be the insurance company?
I didn't hear your question.
I said, I've got a bill I'd like to present to somebody. I don't know whether that's going to be the city or the insurance company.
Well, I'm sure if you wanted to try and put that on to an agenda in the future, we could try and put that on to an agenda in the future or have that be considered. But right now, the issue is the Cruiser and Mitchell, the hiring of Cruiser and Mitchell to represent the city and just when it comes to the subpoenas.
But we don't know who's going to pay for it. That correct? Your answer, you don't know whether it's the insurance company or the city?
I don't know whether the city will ever receive a bill for it. I think is the best response that I can give. I don't know whether the insurance company will pay for it. I don't know whether Cruiser and Mitchell will ever even submit a bill to the city if the insurance company doesn't.
Ms. Woodward's here tonight. Do you think she can answer that question?
I suppose that she might be able to if the insurance company doesn't pay for it. Although she's not, my understanding is she's not the partner responsible for that client, so I'm not sure if it's actually her decision ultimately or not, but she probably does.
So we don't know anything, do we?
No, sir, that's not what I told you at all. What I told you is that the city attorney's office had a conflict, did the proper thing under the circumstances, announced that conflict, recommended the alternate counsel be hired to deal with those subpoenas. What we don't know is whether or not the insurance company will pay for it.
Now, the agent here, can she answer?
I don't know. You'd have to ask the agent.
She said right back then. Gail, can you answer that question?
To the best of my knowledge, yes. I can tell you that right now, everything that has been received in relation to anything that's going on with Mr. Sexton has been submitted to CNA for review. And right now, there has been no determination as to what bills will be paid by CNA and what will not be, because it's under coverage review. So if it turns out that it's a covered matter, then the insurance company will pay the bills that will be submitted from Cruiser and Metro. But right now, it's still under review, it's still being investigated. There haven't been any specific, you know, yes, this is covered, no, this is not covered decisions made by the insurance company yet. So, I mean, unfortunately, I'm like Kevin, I can't give you a specific yes or no answer as to whether or not all of the bills submitted by Cruiser Metro will be paid by CNA, but I do know that anything related to you has been submitted to CNA. They're aware of everything. They hired Cruiser Metro because of the conflict of interest that they have, and everything's being reviewed right now.
Any other questions?
So, Mr. Mayor, your request is that the city authorize the retention of Cruiser Mitchell for this conflict issue and any other conflict issues that come up. Because what I don't want to do is be in a situation where if something comes up next week and we have to do, under the rules of professional conduct, announce if we have a conflict and have somebody else represent the city. I want to make sure we don't have to come back and do this every single time. So the request would be for Cruiser Mitchell to be authorized to be the conflict counsel to represent the city. They're not the city attorney, but to be the conflict counsel to represent the city in the event that the office of the city attorney has a conflict and can't fulfill its duties.
Okay, thank you. Okay, we have a recommendation to hire alternate counsel of Cruiser Mission LLP firm to represent the city in the absence of Dana Miles' law firm. Miles, Astrid Talbot law firm. That takes the regular city attorney out of conflict, correct? I think that's correct. Chairman, entertain a motion. Council. Have a motion and a second. Second. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raise your hand. Any opposed? 3-1, Councilman Sexton opposed. Councilman Curry absent. Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor. The City Council concludes the agenda. I hear a motion to adjourn. Second. All in favor? Any opposed? 4-0. Meet the chairman. Thank you very much. That's all of the time.
Reaction to tonight.
To my motion?
Yes.
Okay. The full council is endorsing what's going on. Which is Angie Mullen Nix, neither Dana Miles or employees of the city of Cumming. So they're endorsing them to have free insurance. That's the bottom line. I tried to correct that. I've been trying to since August of 2014. I've been unsuccessful. The bottom line has been that because I even brought it up, is that they've been railroaded to impeachment by first forming an impartial panel to investigate me, which is the city attorney is on that panel. That's not impartial. That's as partial as you can get, the city attorney. So the other councilmen are endorsing the actions by the council.
You think by them not seconding your motion that that's their seal of approval?
Yeah, it is. Mine was to remove them.
Where's the status of the investigation into your impeachment stand, as you
I've
understand?
I've got a letter here. I haven't had time to read it, but it's a letter from the Attorney General. So they didn't impeach me tonight, so I guess it's a dead issue.
Do you expect that you will or no?
No, I won't be impeached. I've not done anything.
So you did not release the documents?
No. It's public record if I did.
Appreciate your time, sir. Thank you, Sam. Where's the mayor? Did he sneak off?
Yeah, he took good stuff.
Where did the mayor go off? I try to grab one of the council members as they Mr.
Getting his new keys.
I'm sure he's having. He's supposed to be getting a SWAT keys, and his girlfriend has
one. See you too. Excuse me.
Yeah. Let's see y'all later.
Mr. Mayor?
Mr. Mayor, you got
Mr. Mayor, do you have one moment?
Do you have
one moment
just to discuss
tonight, Mr. Mayor?